Good day, everyone. How are you all? Be safe and be good in your home. And please help your parents too. And I hope you are all watching all the videos of English grammar. Okay? Just thank God for this goodness. Okay, my dear children. And in the last tense video session, what we have seen? We have seen the introduction of tenses, introduction of tenses, and we have seen the verb forms, right? The tense forms in a tense table, right? So let me have a short recall on the previous class, and then we will continue to our today's session. Okay, my dear children, and today's session is going to be with the tenses and its usage. We are going to learn what the usage of tenses. Usage of tenses, right? See, we have seen three tenses, right? And each three tenses has four branches. What are the four branches? Simple, continuous, perfect, and perfect continuous. Yes or no, my dear children? So what are all the four branches, my dear children? Simple, continuous, perfect, and perfect continuous. Each tenses has these four branches. Yes or no? Right. See now, my dear children. So in simple, in that verb table, in the tense table, what we have seen, I have told you, right? I have said that simple, we have to concentrate on all be verb, do verb, have verb, action verb. Yes or no? See, be verb, do verb, have verb, and action verb, which means dynamic or any stative verb. And what continuous should have? Continuous will have be verb plus present participle. Be verb plus present participle. And what the perfect form will have? Have verb plus past participle. What a perfect branch, perfect form has, my dear children? That is have verb and past participle. And the next, the last branch, right? What form this perfect continuous has? Perfect continuous has have verb plus been plus present participle. Have verb plus been plus present participle, right? And in this simple, I have told you in present tense alone there is a mantra, right? See, that is what the small tricks I have told you. What are all the tricks to remember? For simple present tense alone, I told SS, PNS, INS and UNS, right? Yes. And now for continuous, what trick I told? Have you remembered that? Yes. For continuous, I have told be prapa. What I told? Be prapa, right? It is like a girl's name, right? Be prapa, right? The same thing, just recall, just remember it in continuous form. What a continuous form, what is the trick of continuous form? It is be prapa. And what is the trick for perfect form, my dear children? That is happy papa. Happy papa, have for have verb and have for happy. That's why I told you perfect form will have happy papa. Okay, my dear children. So what is for, what is this pa means, right? This pa means part past, and next pa is participle, past participle. And here in be prabha, pra which means present, pa which means participle, present participle. Okay, my dear children. So this is for continuous and this is for perfect. And what this perfect continuous have, my dear children? It is have verb plus been plus present participle. What is present participle? Present participle which means adding ing. Present participle which means adding ing. Right, very good. So how you are going to remember this? Have been ing. What I have told, my dear children? Have been ing. Right? Have been ing which means have verb plus been plus ing. Okay, my dear children, don't ever forget this is a complete tense form. Okay, and this is what we are going to use in your spoken, in your writing. Okay, so don't ever forget this forms. Okay, my dear children. So simple will in present simple will have SSPNS, INS, UNS. In continuous will have B Prabha. In perfect will have Happy Papa. And perfect continuous will have Bina NG. Okay, now this is a recall. Okay, now let me tell you the usage of these tenses. These are simple present, present continuous, present perfect continuous, and then past, simple past and past continuous, all these branches, right? Okay, and today we are going to learn only the present four branches. And if you learn this present branches, right, present tense, all kinds of present tense, it will be easy to understand the past and the future. Okay, now let us go into this. Okay, see my dear children, this is past tense, this is our timeline. Okay, have this, and this is our timeline, and what's all happening at this time. Okay, what all happening at this time, right? What all happening at this time says present tense. Okay, the thing, the action which have been completed before this time, so that is called past tense, right? The completed one called past tense. And the what all the actions going to be happened in the next after this time says future. Have you got it, my dear children? Right, so now this is your present tense timeline, I said, and let me have, and today we'll have a date, and what is this? Okay, and this is at present, right? This is 18th June 2020. Okay, we can have 18th June 2020, and the time is, let me have 10:30 a.m. Okay, now what are all the things happening, right? What are all the things happening? I am teaching, right? You are listening, right? And a dog is barking outside. So at this moment, whatever is happening, they are all in present tense. Okay, right. Only whatever the thing happened now is present tense. No, here we have four branches. Simple present, what are all the things we have, my dear children? Say in present tense, even in this timeline, even we have four branches: simple present, present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous. Right, what is simple present? Right, the action to be told, right? See, when an action is a habit, I wake up at 6 a.m. every day. Okay, so this is my habit. This is my habit. So whenever I say about my habit or any habit, we can, habitual action can be told, can be told in what? Simple present tense. In simple present tense, you have to remember your mantra, okay? And general truth, whenever a general truth, we are talking about the action in general truth. For example, earth revolves around the sun. The earth revolves around the sun, right? So this is general truth. You can't change it, I can't change it, right? It's a general truth. We can have the cow gives us milk. So just like this, our general truth, when we are talking about the general truth, it should be present in simple present form. Okay, have you noticed it? Here wake, I didn't add yes. Here revolves, I have added yes. Why? Yes, for I know yes, okay. And for this earth, earth is singular. For singular subject, we have to add yes with the verb, right? So we have added revolves here. Okay, my dear children. Right. And next, fixed arrangement. For example, even though an action is going to happen in the future. For example, a meeting, right, is going to be conducted tomorrow, right? If it is a fixed arrangement, I can say it in present tense. For example, I have a meeting tomorrow, right? I have a meeting tomorrow. Even though tomorrow is a future form, I can say if it is a fixed arrangement, I can make it in present tense. I have a meeting. Have is your present tense verb. Can you understand? So when and all we have to use our simple present tense, my dear children? Yes, whenever we are talking about our habitual action, and whenever we are talking about general truth, and whenever we are talking about fixed arrangements. Okay, so what are all the keywords can be used for this? What are all the keywords can be used for this? See, every day, always, sometimes, never, frequently. For example, I never say like. It is my habit, right? So I can say here, I never say like. Next, frequently. For example, I call my dad frequently. Okay, and sometimes I go for a walk, sometimes, right? And every day, right? I wake up at 6 a.m. every day, and always, yes, I do math interestingly, always. Okay, so these are all the keywords can be used whenever you are talking a thing in simple present tense. Okay, my dear children. So, what is simple present tense in our timeline, my dear children? Have you understood? Right? Not only the thing which is happening at this moment, right? When it is our habit. When it is our habit. Yesterday also I woke up at 6 a.m. Today also I wake up at 6 a.m. And tomorrow also I will wake up at 6 a.m. So, this is my habit. Right? It doesn't consider it is yesterday, it is a future. No. Whenever I talk about the general truth, habit, right? I have to say it in simple present tense. Okay, my dear children. And now, present continuous. What is present continuous? That is what you expected, my dear children. Right? What is happening at this moment? Right? This is our timeline, right? What is happening at this moment can be said in present continuous. Present continuous. For example, see, whenever we have to use, see, now. What are all the things happening? Your mom is cooking. See, what are all the example can I say now? Your mom is cooking. Yeah? Your sisters are playing. So, these are all present continuous. How have you found this is present continuous? Here, you find this, right? Be verb and here ing, present participle. So, a present continuous should have be verb with ing. I told, right, be Prabha, right? So my mom is cooking, sisters are playing. At this moment, whatever is happening, we can say it in present continuous. And now at this moment, right, the same now and at this moment, right, the action which is going on at this moment. Now longer action progress. Now very important, my dear children, longer action progress now. For example, if I do my doctorate, okay, if I do my doctorate, right, and I am eating now, right, at this moment, I am eating. And if somebody asks me, what are you doing? Generally, now about my studies, if they ask, what I have to say, I am doing my doctorate. How to answer, my dear children? I am doing my doctorate. Okay. So it is not compulsory. The at the moment only we have to add present continuous. If it is a longer action, it still in progress also can be used in present continuous. Okay, my dear children. And next one, near future. Near future, which means the same thing, fixed, like fixed arrangement, even though it happened in future. Simple present tense we used, right? The same thing for near future, right? So what is near future, my dear children? For example, my brother, see, my brother is coming tonight. Is coming tonight. See, this is not night, this is morning. This is morning, and I am saying my brother is coming tonight. Tonight, right? Night is going to come. It is in the future, right? But it is near future. It is near future. In such case, it is a confirmed one. It is a confirmed one. So I use present continuous be verb with ing. My brother is coming tonight. Suppose you have used, right? I am going for a picnic tomorrow, right? Tomorrow is a future. But as it is a near future or a confirmed action, you are going to say it in present continuous. Okay, my dear children. Right, now come here for present perfect. Okay, what is present perfect? Here is your interesting action, right, going to happen. You will exclaim, what is this present perfect if I say? See, what is simple present tense? Habitual, general, truth, and fixed arrangement is simple present tense, right? And present continuous, right? Whatever happens at that moment and longer action or near future. And this present perfect, right? An action started in the past. Just imagine an action started in the past. And it is continuing, 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 and end. And it stopped recently. See, this is our timeline, and our action completed recently, recently to our timeline. An action continued and end up recently. So in such cases, we have to say it in present perfect. How to say, my dear children? So you can ask, ma'am, this is completed. No, ma'am. So it is past tense. Right. Superb. It is past tense. Yeah, it means a completed action. Correct. But it is joining till now. It is what it means, an action which has happened till now. Okay, my dear children, that is why we include this as present perfect. Present perfect. What is the perfect form, my dear children? Happy papa. So we have to add have verb plus past participle. Have verb plus past participle. That is what present perfect. Okay, now what are all the keywords? Let us start learning. Shall we start, my dear children? Yes. See, what are all the whenever we have to use present perfect? An action completed recently, right? This is our timeline. An action started from the past and it was continuing and end up recently. So an action completed recently, in such places we have to use present perfect. And till now, what happened? Till now, what happened? When we say that, we have to say it in present perfect. And change over time, right? Many of your neighbors or your relatives must have told you this. You have grown up. You have grown up, right? See, when I was looking at you, than that you have grown up. They might have told you. That is what change over time. Now, uncompleted action, right? So till now, If any action is incomplete or uncompleted, that can be said in present perfect. Okay, my dear children. So, now listen, what are all the keywords? See, already, right? What are all the keywords, my dear children? It is already, for, since, yet, never, always, so far, recently. Okay, so if I give you some example, you will understand, I think so. Okay, let me give you some example with this happy papa. What is happy papa? The form of perfect tense, right? See, now example, I have never gone to London, right? I have never gone to London. See, what does it mean? Till this time, at this moment, till this moment, right, from the past to now, I have never gone to London. Okay, it shows the timeline. Can you understand, my dear children? Right, now, the bell has rung. The bell has rung, right? So, the bell, which means the bell is now ringing? No, recently it rang. Okay, my dear children, it is completed. The action is completed. The bell has rung. When the period gets over, the bell used to ring, right? That is what? The bell has rung. So, here, for have, here I have used have verb, have. And here I have used has. Why? This is present perfect, right? What is present tense perfect have verb, my dear children? What are all the have verb? Haven, has, no. So, for singular, we have to add yes. So, the bell is singular. I have added yes with this. Okay, my dear children? And near this happy, what is here? Rung. Rung is a past participle. Verb 3 form, right? Ring, rang, rung. Okay, my dear children. And now, I have never gone. So, here, gone is your verb, right? So, here, have gone. For I know, yes. That's why I have used have here and gone, right? Gone is your past participle, right? Verb 3 form. Go, went, gone. Okay, my dear children. Okay, so I hope you have understood this present perfect continuous well. Okay, whenever this, when and where it should be used, my dear children, an action completed recently, and when we say an action happened till now, change over time and uncompleted action. And now here, present perfect continuous. See, present perfect continuous. With this name even, you will understand what is present perfect continuous. Continuous. What is present perfect? What is present perfect? A present perfect, which means an action. Present perfect, which means an action started in the past. And it's continuing and completed recently, right? That is what present perfect. And guess what is continuous? Yes, it is continuing still. Even though it started in the past, it's still continuing, it's going on. We can't say when it will finish. We can't say when it will complete. Okay, my dear children. And what is present perfect continuous form, my dear children? Perfect continuous form. Right? Continuous, ing should be there. So, perfect, have verb plus past participle should be there. So, what is going to adjust there? Have been, ing. What is the form? Have been, ing. Right? Verb with ing. Don't forget, verb with ing. For example, okay, let me give you an example. I have been doing my project. I have been doing my project since 2000 2019, right? I have been doing my project since 2019, which means from 2019, this is your past tense. Now this is 2020, our timeline is 18, right? So in 2019 even I have started, right? Since says the starting time, since says the starting time. So in 2019 itself my action started and it is continuing. Have I completed my project? I didn't complete my project, it's still going on. I have started in the past, but still I am doing that. I have been doing my project since 2019. Suppose if I cut this, I have done my project. I have done my project since 2019. What does it mean? Whether I have completed or still doing, right? I have completed. This is completed. See, from 2019, since 2019, even I started doing it. But I have completed recently. But it doesn't mention any time. Present perfect doesn't mention any time. When it completed, it shows, right, recently or sometime, right, somewhere, it happened at any time, but it never says any time, particularly last year, last month, it won't say. But simple past tense will say this thing. Okay, my dear children. So I hope, my dear children, you have understood this present tense branches, right? What are all the present tense branches? Simple present, present continuous, then present perfect, and present perfect continuous. Simple present says your general truth, habitual action and fixed arrangements. Present continuous says what all the action is going on at this moment, and longer action which is progress now. But with here it has an end. But in present perfect continuous, we can't guess when an action will complete, right? But your present continuous will guess. See, if you are studying 7th standard, you can say within 1 year we will complete this, right? So such cases you can use present continuous. Okay, and near future, it's a confirmed action in present. We can say it in present continuous. And what is present perfect? An action which is completed recently, and till now an action is going on, and a change over time, uncompleted action. So these cases we can use present perfect tense. And your present perfect continuous tense, right? An action started in the past, but it is still continuing, and it will go than present also. It will go in the future also, but we can't guess when it will complete. Okay, my dear children. So this is your present form. Okay, and in the next video session you will be easily understanding past and the future forms. Okay, and remember this, if you can't understand, again, once again, save it, download it, and see again, look at these videos again and again, look at the examples, and so try to do the exercises, remember these keywords, which will help you to understand tenses very much better. Okay, my dear children. So till the next class, it is bye from me. Bye bye.